What's going on, everyone? Rabid here. You know what to do. Smash that subscribe button, thumbs up button, as well as bell notification. Let's get into this. The RX 6600 non-XT has been released the other day. So we're going to look at some hash rates, ROI on this card, and see if it's actually worth it. Depending on what you're mining and how you're mining it, everyone's view on the situation will be different. So I'm just going to give you my take on it. You guys have been asking me to do a video in emails, of all things, so I figured I'd just do it. I do not have one myself, but other people have tested this card. Links will be in the description for anything used here. First sources, I'm going to be using Dizzy Mining. He always gets cards. He's first in line. So if you're looking for the fastest updates on a hash rate for Ethereum, check out Dizzy Mining. Again, link in the description, as well as Chump Change, who did a video on that earlier today as well. He was testing out a rig, and he also had a watt meter hooked up. So we're going to be looking at that as well. And again, if you want to check out all those straight videos for yourself, a link to each specific video and their channel will be in the description below. First up here, we do have courtesy of Dizzy Mining, who always gets GPUs like right on release. So he'll have a hash rate video out day of release, no matter what. So if you don't know about his channel, be sure to check it out. Looks like he is getting 28.97 mega hash in Windows here with an Afterburner OC of 1900 on the mem, and he's doing a 1305 core. So I think he's using the voltage design or something here in order to do that, because obviously he has it way down below in the minuses, and it's not saying minuses. A lot of people say use the AMD software for this. You can and you can't, depending how you're running your system. If you're using CPU mining as well or something, you're operating through Ryzen Master, the AMD GPU software conflicts with Ryzen Master. So they don't like to play with each other. You end up with system crashes and all sorts of other things. So they don't like to play well together. So depending what you are doing, yes, the AMD software is okay for Windows by itself, but not if you're mixing it with other AMD software. For some reason, they're just glitchy and they don't like to play with each other. I don't know if it's two different software departments that don't get along and they're always fighting, but that's almost the way it seems. So here we are, Windows 28.97 mega hash. And it looks like the power draw here in the software is saying about 55. So that's not too bad. We do know that software power lies a bit, but seems with these newer GPUs, it is a lot closer than what it used to be. Okay, guys, next up, we do have Mr. Chump Change XD here. And it looks like him in HiveOS is getting 28.91 mega hash across the board on the majority of the cards here. And then 28.89 on the bottom. It doesn't really matter. 28.9 does look like a nice average here. But as for the watt meter, it's doing 309.5 watts total system with all five of these cards. So that is pretty insane. I kind of broke down the numbers here. Looking at 309.5 watts, that is 61.9 watts per GPU. So that's divided by five. Now there's still a little bit taken off the system here. I didn't calculate that into it, based my numbers off that number. So we're looking at 61.9 watts. It could be down depending on the system of possibly 10 to 20 watts, even less than that. It's hard to say because then that would be lower than the software numbers, but we have no idea what's going on here. So that works out to be a 0.46 mega hash per watt per card. So that is extremely efficient. That is better than a 3060 Ti. That's pretty insane here. But looking at the price of these cards, we are looking at $589.99 USD for one of these. And this is the 6600 mech in Canada listed at Memory Express. And this is like the bottom grade of the cards. Now, I recommend XFX. You know, your Sapphires are the top of line cards, Pulse and Nitros. And they all have dual BIOS switches. When it comes down to it, I recommend dual BIOS switches. That way you can play around. Possibly we could flash the XT BIOS onto the 6600 like we did with the 5700s. Who knows? But I wouldn't play around with that unless you actually do have that switch. So highly recommended to buy the version that does have the dual BIOS switch. That way you can do a lot more tweaking and playing around and not have to worry about bricking it too bad, because it's very easy to fix. I threw these numbers into Ethereum just to check out what kind of profitabilities we are looking like. And it is looking like $1.99 after power. These things don't use that much power at all. $2.14 before, $1.99 after. So a quick $2. I have to swap that over to Canadian so I can see what that is, so I can look at my ROI. And that is $2.47 per Canadian dollar. So $2.47 divided by 589. That gives us an ROI of about 238 days. So about 2/3 of a year. That's not too bad. But think about it, 6 months from now, you are looking at Ethereum 2.0 possibly, unless it gets extended again and even longer. And that is only like 160 some days. So you may not ROI this card in time for Ethereum 2.0, but you can mine other coins. Check out that Chump Change video. He does some Ergo hash rates. He does some Ravencoin hash rates. So you can kind of see the performance across those other coins as well. But what is this card really? It is most likely, in my mind, it is an overpriced RX 580 that is a lot more efficient. So it uses about half the power of an RX 580, but it gets about the same amount of hash rate. This is actually a little bit less than a 580. But again, half the power. You can find the RX 580 for like the same amount of hash rates for a lot cheaper than this newer card. But you know, you may get higher resale value down the road. Other things that does come with owning a newer version of a card than a lot older one. Now, is it worth it? I guess it would depend on availability. They're probably all sold out right across the board right now, because everywhere I look in Canada, they're gone. Either we just didn't hardly get any in. We don't usually get too much stuff in Canada. So maybe you guys in the USA, you probably do have lots in stock or something, but most likely everything is out of stock. I'm seeing Amazon already has them listed for like $1,000. But here we are at Best Buy. A 3060 Ti, so it is slightly less efficient, not by much. They're pretty close. I think it's 0.42 is the efficiency hash to watt ratio on a 3060 Ti, but we're pulling 62 mega hash here at about 130 to 136 watts, but we're actually a little bit cheaper if you can get this at a Best Buy drop. And again, the Founders Edition, 3060 Ti, 3070, and 3080s are all non-LHR, but you can only get them from a Best Buy, and you have to get them at a drop. So that means standing in line. So this is what I do. This is the only way I get it, because these are still the best bang for your buck in performance, but availability is really low. AMD raised all their prices. I don't know what happened there. They marketed as being cheaper than Nvidia, but now everything is higher MSRP standpoint. So it's pretty insane what's happening there. So let me know in the comments, guys, what do you guys think? Are you going to be getting these 6,600 cards? Are you going to be waiting? Are you going to be standing in line for Best Buy like I do? I don't really think the 6600 XT and the 6600 is really worth it in my mind, because it's just an overpriced newer version with more efficiency of an RX 580 card. So again, let me know in the comments, guys. Hit that subscribe button, thumbs up button, like button. I'll catch you on the next one. Rabid out.
Thank you for watching, everyone. If you haven't, please comment, subscribe, and like this video, as well as check out one of these other videos if you have not seen it yet. I do try to stream every Saturday and Sunday, so stay tuned for more future content.